Hello children, today I'm going to discuss with you the first term lesson Romeo and Juliet, Act 1, Scene 3, 4, 5. Now let's discuss the important points in Act 1, Scene 3. This scene introduces Juliet on stage and explores the theme of youth versus old age and difference in attitudes between the nurse, Lady Capulet, and Juliet towards love and the marriage. So you can see a picture of Juliet, Lady Capulet, and nurse, and how they are talking about Juliet's marriage. So Lady Capulet and the nurse call Juliet to enter the scene. Lady Capulet wants to talk to her daughter Juliet about the possibility of marriage. Here, the nurse provides much of the comic relief throughout the play. Her pointless stories often touch with embarrassing or sad details from her own past. For an example, children, she reveals that the Capulets employed her after her own baby daughter Suzanne has died. From there onwards, she became Juliet's wet nurse. So they have a very strong relationship than Juliet's real mother, Lady Capulet. So Shakespeare wanted to convey us nurse's character as she is playing the surrogate mother's role to Juliet. They discuss the fact that Juliet still has 2 weeks left before her 14th birthday. But as Lady Capulet points out, plenty of girls her age are mothers already. So when we discuss about Lady Capulet and Juliet's relationship, they have distant relationship. Because Lady Capulet is expecting Juliet's complete obedience in agreeing to the marriage. Juliet is clearly reluctant to agree to the arranged marriage, as she says, "It is an honor that I dreamt not of." Lady Capulet considers Juliet to be old enough for marriage. Besides, a marriage to Paris would bring increased social status and wealth for the Capulets. So this can be the strong reason why she wanted her daughter to push to the marriage. Juliet is open to marriage, although she admits she has not thought much about it. So as I told you, now still as she's in her age 13, she does not have very good experience about the marriage. So Lady Capulet tells her that handsome Paris is interested in taking her as his wife. So now, as I told you in my earlier slide, so Lady Capulet is telling this fact with the intention that she wanted her daughter to marry because they can increase the social status and wealth from this marriage. But Juliet says she'll keep an open mind. In the meantime, the Capulet party has just begun. So while Lady Capulet sees Paris as the chance to make a socially advantageous match for the family, rather than considering Juliet's feelings, the nurse regards marriage as purely physical relationship, almost a burden women simply must bear. So they have two contradictory views as experienced women. So here Shakespeare points out to the reader, Juliet is not even 14 and yet her parents are pushing her towards adult decisions in order to further their own social capital. So she is being told she's old enough to get married and yet still being treated like a child by those around her. Not only that, but also Shakespeare shows us, even though Juliet is clearly uncertain about the entire concept of love, her mother and nurse need her to love and focus instead on what makes a sensible match. Juliet is doubtful of this, suggesting that when she does meet someone with whom she has real attraction, she will be quick to run in her elder's advice. So this scene will foreshadow in upcoming scene 2, scene 3, how she is running to the forceful attraction and how she is taking quick decisions due to her elders' unwanted advisors. Now we'll be discussing the significant events which had happened in Act 1, Scene 4. So as readers, we already know that Romeo and his friends are headed to the feast. Romeo, Benvolio and their friend Mercutio arrive at Capulet party in style. Romeo tells his friend that he does not plan on dancing tonight. He is too sad. So why he is too sad? Because though he loves Rosaline, Rosaline does not love him. So Benvolio, as a very good friend who is dealing with things in a realistic way, is helping Romeo to understand that Rosaline's love is a impartial love. Only Romeo loves her, so he wanted Romeo to be practical. However, the scene does make the general sense of fate through Romeo's statement of belief that the night's events will lead to untimely death. Why I'm telling so? Because he had a dream that the night before that gave him a bad feeling about the party. So Mercutio teasingly thinks his dream is the result of a visit from Queen Map. She is the miniature fairy's midwife who visits people in their sleep and fulfills their desires in dreams. This scene also serves as introduction to the clever charm Mercutio. He is established as a friend who can gently or not tease Romeo as no one else can. Benvolio does not have the quick capacity for such behavior. With his wild speech and laughter, Mercutio is a man of immoderate behavior. But his passions are of another sort than those that move Romeo to love and Tybalt to hate. So Mercutio's Queen Map speech is one of the most famous in the play. Queen Map, who brings dreams to sleeping people, seems to be loosely based on figures in the pagan Celtic mythology that predated Christianity's arrival in England. After his speech, Mercutio points out to Romeo that dreams are nothing but vain fantasy as they head into the party. Romeo says he has a strange feeling that what happens next will lead to his untimely death, but as he is ready to accept whatever fate brings. So again, you can see how Shakespeare brings out the theme fate throughout these scenes. Now we'll be in Act 1, Scene 5. This is the moment we have all been waiting for. A very famous scene in the drama Romeo and Juliet. At Capulet's house, Romeo and his friends enter as the preparations are being made for the dancing. The musicians are tuning up and the servants are hurrying to clear away the remains of the feast. Capulet enters, greets the masked strangers and invites them to dance. So you can see the picture of Romeo and Juliet, how they are dancing at the feast. So Romeo sees Juliet and says to himself that this is the first time he has seen true beauty. So now we can see after Romeo sees Juliet, and forgets Rosaline entirely, Rosaline's memory. He already forget about Rosaline. Juliet meets Romeo and falls just as deep in love. So, like Romeo, Juliet also fall after she sees Romeo. She also, what had happened, falls just as deeply in love. When Romeo sees Juliet for the first time, he is struck by her beauty and breaks into a sonnet. The imagery Romeo uses to describe Juliet gives important insights into their relationship. So the first conversation between Romeo and Juliet is an extended metaphor. Using this metaphor, Romeo cleverly manages to convince Juliet to let him kiss her. Romeo compares Juliet to an image of a saint that should be a revered, a role that Juliet is willing to play. There is a dramatic contrast between Tybalt's hatred and Romeo's and Juliet's love. Here we can see how Romeo and Juliet share a duet in which they make formal declarations of love to each other. For an example, Romeo is telling, "My lips, two blushing pilgrims, too smooth that rough touch with a tender kiss." And Juliet is telling, "Good pilgrim, you do wrong your hand too much," which mannerly devotion showing in this. So these lines can be taken as 14 line sonnet with a rhyme scheme of A, B, A, B, C, D, C, D, E, F, E, F, G, G. Romeo initially describes Juliet as a source of light, like a star against the darkness. She doth teach the torches to burn bright. It seems she hangs upon the cheek of night. As the play progresses, a cloak of interwoven light and dark images is cast around the pair. So the lovers are repeatedly associated with the dark, an association that points to the secret nature of their love, because this is the time they are able to meet in safety. So with this sonnet, Shakespeare finds a means an expressing perfect love and linking it to a tragic fate of Romeo and Juliet. So that fate begins to assert itself in the instant when Romeo and Juliet first meet. Tybalt recognizes Romeo's voice when Romeo's first exclaims at Juliet's beauty. At the same time, the light and surrounds of lovers in each other's eyes grows brighter to the very end when Juliet's beauty even illuminates the dark of the tomb. The association of both Romeo and Juliet with the stars also continually reminds the audience that their fate is star-crossed. Tybalt recognizes Romeo and sends for his sword, but Capulet orders Tybalt to do nothing, saying that he'll make Romeo pay Tybalt's leaves. So Capulet, acting very carefully, stops Tybalt from taking immediate action, but Tybalt's anger is set, creating the circumstances that will eventually banish Romeo from Verona. In the meeting between Romeo and Juliet lie the seeds of their shared tragedy. So we can see these scenes from Act 3 to scene Act 1, Scene 3 to Scene 5 are the turning points which Shakespeare link the story to the tragedy of the play. So children, I already made some questions for you. So again, you go and revise what I already had taught you through this video, and again get a very good clear understanding, and refer the student book and refer your textbook and write the write the correct answers to these questions. So thank you very much, children, for listening to my presentation.